Can we now move to the third dialogue, which is titled WASH and Community Engagement in Cholera Hotspots, Bringing Evidence to Action in Households, Health Facilities, and Within Communities. The dialogue will be moderated by Dr. Firdausi Quadri, who's from the International Center for Diarrheal Disease and Research in Bangladesh. Thank you. Over to you, Dr. Quadri.
Thank you, Dr. Benson. So it's a pleasure to be here and to hear about cholera and not COVID-19 for a break. And so I will give a brief introduction before handing it over to the fantastic speakers we have today. So worldwide, 2.2 million people still lack access to safe drinking water. More than half of the global population do not have access to safe sanitation. Significant inequalities in equity exist in access to wash. Over 60% people lack basic safe water facilities and basic sanitation facilities. 3 billion people do not have access to hand washing facilities with soap, which many of us just take for granted. Still, 673 million people practice open defecation. To add to this is the global problem of food and waterborne diseases. The topic of our discussion today is the long-standing burden of cholera, which even to this day, whether it's an old disease or a new disease, causes 2.9 million cases and over around 100,000 deaths. It continues to be seen and increased in conflicts, climate change, urbanization, population growth in resource-poor settings in Asia, Africa, and elsewhere, as seen in recent times. Sensitizing decision makers and continued advocacy for adequate resource allocations to achieve targets in national cholera plans is absolutely essential. We will need to move quickly to accelerate multi-sectoral action at country, regional, and global levels to end cholera. We have lost time due to the pandemic of COVID-19 in both vaccination and wash efforts for elimination of cholera, and so we have to move fast. In Bangladesh alone, we had one of the largest demonstration projects, from which the second dose could not be given because of COVID-19 in 2020. The investment in wash services, infrastructure, supplies and training, and innovative tools which you're going to hear about today and ideas are needed in accordance with the WHO 72.7 resolution. It is the center of the SDG 6, while cholera control is embedded in SDG 3. So the urgent investment in water, sanitation, and hygiene is required to achieve the goals of the global roadmap to ending cholera by 2030 and to secure progress towards universal health funds.